I want to turn now to CNN legal analyst Elliot Williams. Also, Dr. Rashaan Ray, professor of sociology at the University of Maryland, is here. And CNN law enforcement analyst Michael Fanone, also with us on this panel. Gentlemen, you know, when you hear the idea of how many officers were present, and you think about where things are right now with the release of the footage, this is close to home for you in particular, Dr. Rashaan Ray, because this is your hometown community as well. But when you're watching it, based on, you know, you train officers as well, and your work as sociologists, what was your impression now that you have seen this video in the presence of more than five officers on that scene?
Well, yeah, Laura, I mean, I'm a native Tennessean. I went to the University of Memphis. Training police officers, working with hundreds of them, the big thing that stood out to me is I'm wondering if culture is actually reformable. See, we're talking about policy change, and I think that's a big movement that we're seeing in Memphis, that people are protesting, saying, look, we are holding our legislators accountable, which is different from saying we're just going to hold law enforcement accountable. People are recognizing that lawmakers actually make the laws. But we need culture to change. And policy can do a lot, but culture is something different. And when I watched that video and I saw the lack of duty to intervene, it highlighted what I always say about how bad apples come from rotten trees, that we're focusing on these five individuals, but it's very clear that there is a structural leak at play, not just in the Memphis Police Department, but in other police departments around the country.
That's an interesting thing about the culture, and can it be reformed? And I do want to ask you one more question on that point, because there's, you know, as somebody who's trained officers yourself, do we have to train humanity? Because that's something you would hope would be innate. We know that it's not always.
Yeah, I mean, most definitely. So we have a virtual reality training program at the University of Maryland, and we put officers in the type of situations that they encounter every single day. But I've also served on peace officer standards and trainings commissions. And the big thing I know there is that individuals are getting through kind of this leaky pipeline to become police officers, where a decade or two ago, they might not have been able to get through. But police departments really need bodies. So what ends up happening is you get these individuals that come in who are highly problematic, who people know that are problematic. And in this case, individuals who might have came, say, from corrections to police departments or from other units to this unit, and they get passed by. The buck just gets passed around until these particular incidents happen. And so it is a lack of humanity, but it is also a lack of a structural issue at play within police departments. So when I hear Chief Davis make statements like, oh, yeah, essentially that we have a leadership problem, that suggests to me not only is it about humanity, but it's also about the fact that we have a leaky pipeline that has allowed unqualified individuals morally from a humanity standpoint to even be police officers in the first place.
Last word.
Yeah, look, video matters. We've seen it in a very, very big way. Biden talked about trauma. Community trauma is big. These illness spillovers of police violence matters. We need to focus on people's mental health to heal people. Research documents that people who live in overly policed communities suffer when it comes to their mental and physical health, and that needs to be primary. But Memphis got a lot of things right. People should follow suit.
We'll see if it becomes the blueprint. A very fine point indeed. Everyone stick around. Some of the five fired Memphis police officers accused in the fatal beating of Tyre Nichols were members of the Memphis Police Scorpion Unit. We're talking about that today, and it's meant to tackle rising crime in the city. Well, now that unit is inactivated and it also is under review. So what comes next?